That has a coral in it, dude. Not cool. Now you got sand all over you. Stop. Don't. Oh my god, what is he doing? Why are you doing that to my coral? What? Oh my god, you're like building a freaking cave? What are you doing? Hey guys, so today's video is going to be not one of those videos that is necessarily entertaining to everyone, but just one of those educational how-to videos. Today, I'm going to be showing you guys how to set up an RODI unit. Yeah, we're gonna be doing it the really simple way today, which is just hooking it up in your laundry, The way I'm doing it is probably like the easiest way possible to do it, which is just setting it up in your washing machine area. So if you're looking how to set it up in your sink or something, this is not gonna help you at all. If you buy a brand new RODI unit, if you go buy one at the store, it comes with everything you need except for a laundry machine. You need a Y fitting to put two different little outputs on there. My terminology is probably a little poor here, like I just said, you know, you need the Y fitting so you have two different outputs. Like, basically, you just watch me do this, okay? The RODI unit I set up today is a 150 gallon per day RODI unit from Bulk Resupply. So it's 6 stages. I think RODI water is the way to go with any kind of saltwater fish whatsoever, but especially for those more sensitive species. I really do believe an RODI unit will make your whole reef keeping experience so much more successful. The reason I set it up was for my seahorses, because seahorses absolutely need them if you're gonna be keeping them. They have to have RODI water. Tap water is just gonna slowly kill them. Like, I'm sorry, it's just gonna happen. I'm getting a 150. Hopefully soon here. I'm still waiting on it, but I'm getting a 150 hopefully pretty soon here. I'm still waiting on it. RODI is just reverse osmosis deionization. It takes all the impurities out of your water and leaves nothing but the water for the fish. You don't really need to use it for fresh water. If you're going to be using it for fresh water, just make sure to get something that will add those good elements back into the water that the freshwater fish and especially freshwater plants need that will be taken out during the reverse osmosis deionization process. Filmed this whole process when I was doing it. Hopefully I correctly portrayed everything during it. It was my first time using my GoPro, and yeah, I'm just hoping I did everything correctly. Today we're gonna be setting up my new RODI unit. This is my old one. That one's gonna be sold, and this is my new one. Bulk Reef Supply sent it to me. It's like an early fish Christmas. It is 6 stages. Here are the first 4. Here are the next 2. Today I'm gonna be setting it up in my washing machine area, and it's very simple actually. So we're gonna go ahead and get started now. Okay, so this right here, this red line, right here is where the water will be coming in. So you attach this red hosing to the intake area. Since I'm doing 6 stages, this blue piece right here is actually going to connect to my next 2 stages. If it was not going to be connecting to there, this would just be what is giving you the water. So this would be the outtake. Then lastly, this black is the waste. So you take this wastewater line and you stick it down in your wastewater section. For wastewater, if you're doing it in the washing machine area, it's literally where this big black hose is in the center. I'm sorry, this is dusty, but it literally just gets shot down right in there with it. So it's pretty easy. I'm gonna be mounting it since it is so heavy, and I've just marked where I'm going to be mounting because it's kind of hard to see as it like hides underneath there. So I'm gonna mark where I need to drill there, and then mount it. Okay, so now they are mounted up here, so they're not gonna fall. I have the TDS meter present where I can see it visibly. And now I just got to set up all the wiring and actually get it connected. So if you do get the dual ones, they don't come already like all in one. You just got it. It's really simple. You just take the blue. This is where the good water comes out of. And all you have to do is connect this tube of good water to your DI unit. It goes through here, goes through the first one, goes through the second one, and spits back out here. I'm gonna go ahead and see if I can't swap this one out since it is pretty short with a longer one that I have. All right, it looks like it worked. It's not coming out, so it looks pretty connected. So I just replaced the tubing it came with a longer one, because this one will actually make it to the trash can that I'm using to fill it up. All I did was connect the 2 units together right there. And that's literally all I did. Next thing you're gonna do is take the red tubing or whatever, depending on your, you know, you might get a different RODI unit, so the tubing might be different. But what you're looking for is the tube that connects right here
It starts right on the side and goes into these three units. So you're looking for this tube right here, and it connects.
This connects to your water source, which if you're using the laundry room like I am, that will be your good water right here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this right here, this little adapter that I got at Lowe's or Home Depot or wherever, and we're gonna screw it onto this part of the adapter, and it literally goes on very easily. You just, hold on, let me get it facing the right way. It literally screws right on. You just keep going till it don't go no more. And then we're good here. And we're gonna take this one and we are going to stick it in there. It's literally that easy. And we just stick it in till it doesn't come out. If you ever do need to get it out, you just pinch on the sides and it pulls out. But you just wanna make sure it's really in there because you don't want the water to go somewhere else. Because I've flooded these floors too many times, trust me, I know how it goes. Lastly, we take your wastewater line, which is going to come out of the top of the membrane up here. We're going to take the wastewater and we are going to put it in the wastewater area. Now, if you're using a washing machine again, if you look down here, that's your tube of where the wastewater comes out of for your washing machine. All you do is you follow that and see where it goes. Obviously, here it goes right there. So we take this wastewater, I'm actually gonna move it so it's not sticking out of here. And we're gonna send it down this tube. And that is literally all you gotta do. All I did was clip the wire that connects to the water supply, and I added a stop switch, an on and off little switch. This is just one way to make sure it actually, you know, turns off when you don't want it on. All you do is the switch that I installed, you just turn it that way, and it turns it off. It is stopping now. Me. Just so y'all know, in about 5 days, I'm going to be doing my next Subscriber Sunday video, so if you have anything you'd like to send in for that video, please go ahead and do it, and I will mention your name if you leave a name and your like Twitter handle or Instagram handle or YouTube handle if you leave that in there. Also, I am not sure when my next live stream is going to be. I'd like to think sometime this week. I will keep y'all updated on that. I will let y'all know for sure in my next video when my next live stream is going to be, so keep your eyes open, keep your eyes peeled. Okay, so for those of you asking on updates on my seahorse, I'm pretty sure Nova's babies have not survived. There's no more movement in the tank, like they aren't wiggling around like they were. And they really only moved around for the first like 15 minutes and then they stopped, so I really don't think there was any chance of them surviving to begin with. They were really, really underdeveloped, so I wasn't expecting it. Like, I'm not surprised. It's not that I didn't try, it's just I kind of knew they weren't gonna make it. The other seahorses are still being babysat at the aquarium shop that I have them at. And then Nova is still here and he's still not eating. So part of me wants like just to let nature take its course and just to keep, you know, taking care of him and not force feeding him, because force feeding him just seems a little bit crazy. Stick a catheter down his throat. Like, I don't know. Like, if there has to be a reason he's not eating is what I think. So why would I force food down his throat? But then the other part of me says, you know, he needs me to help him. So I probably still will try force feeding at least once, but if it just seems too stressful, I might stop after that. It just depends on if he starts to improve or not. Because if he does not improve and I already like forced food down his throat once, what's the point of doing it again, you know? He is still alive, and my other two erectus females are doing great, and my mandarin is doing great. They're all being watched, like I said. And then Solara is still doing great, actually. I remember, you know, like when I first found out Solara was sick about, you know, 2 months ago, I really didn't think she even had a month left. And she's still going really strong. She just doesn't exercise anymore. She comes out and eats, goes to the restroom, and goes back to sleep. But She still seems to be very, you know, alert and aware and making an effort to live. So I mean, things are going really good with her, I guess. It's going a lot better than I expected. I'm going to be doing a video soon about my planted tank. I know y'all have been asking about that. I was letting it kind of cycle because I had so many things to worry about that I was just letting that tank cycle and do its thing. And now I have went ahead and put my order in for my new plants from buseplant.com. Like I told you guys before, I do have a discount code for that website. Any plants y'all want, you can get 15% off with the coupon code TaylorDeanBuse. And make sure to check out that website I told you all about in my last video, the My Aquarium Life, myaquarium.life. We are still working on that website, of course. It's a work in progress, but it's coming along really nice. And we're just trying to get, you know, some people over there and to start getting the site going. We will be doing giveaways on there, like a bio cube we're gonna be giving away on there and a few things like that. Like I said, that's just gonna be a place where I talk about a lot of my aquarium stuff that I won't be having the time to mention in all my videos and stuff, so. Yes, thank y'all guys for watching, and I hope y'all guys have had a wonderful day, and I will talk to you next time, and you will see me next time. Bye guys.
Days and weeks would pass, I thought that we were history, till one night I got your text and all it said is that you miss me. Honestly, I cried, those feelings cut me deep inside, I tried to give